So in our purchase or pass segment this week, we take a look at another investment that has something slightly different about it, and we discuss whether that would make it something to invest in or something to avoid. Now, it's a two-bedroom unit, 7.9 kilometres from the CBD and less than 200 metres from the action. It's on a very quiet back street, so you get all the advantages of location, but without the noise. It has a carport out the front, and there's a very leafy shared deck and gardens out the back. Now, the block has only got four units in it, but the point of contention is that the strata is self-managed by the owners. So is that an advantage or something to be avoided at all costs? So, Stuart, I guess the first thing is look, pretty much everything matches for location, size of block and all the rest of it, so that's pretty good. What are maybe some of the downsides of having a self-managed strata?
You're not always going to have the same interests as the same as a person managing your property. So usually, you know, a strata manager will come in and usually govern the whole board meeting as far as between all the owners, and therefore you get your say as far as what you want to happen to the building, what input you want to have, what kind of budget you want to spend on those kind of improvements. But if you've got somebody who's, you know, doing all that kind of job for you that lives in the building, they might try and, you know, persuade you that their interests are actually the best interests for the property.
And quite often in those things, when, especially if there's an owner that's maybe been there for 40 or 50 years and you're all fairly new owners in there, then quite often they're a pretty dominating factor, and no matter what the law is, then they're pretty much running the show and you've got no chance of getting in.
Exactly right. I mean, the first thing you're going to do when you buy a property is you're going to want to put your kind of touches on your own little property, but also you're going to want to put some touches around the surrounding grounds and the common property. And you're right, Chris, I mean, usually if someone has been there for a longer period of time, they believe they've spent the money they need to spend on the property, therefore they're very reluctant to spend any more money on the property. And if there is no money in the sinking fund, well, therefore they're going to have to raise special levies. So it can be quite a big kind of persuasion away from this kind of property.
But at the same time, it can be something that people can change straight away. There's nothing to stop them hiring strata managers and get it all in, and then suddenly overnight, then you've got a properly managed building.
Exactly right. The costs aren't that big. I mean, I was talking to a strata manager today, coincidentally, and you're right, the cost as far as hiring a strata manager is not that great, and you can do it quite quickly. The only thing is you've got to find a good one, and there's not a great deal of good ones in the market, you know as well as I do.
Yeah. So what would you reckon, a purchase or a pass?
I thought this was a purchase. I liked it.
Yeah. And look, when choosing a potential investment, I tend to concentrate on the big picture. Issues such as location and renovation potential are much more important to me. So whilst it is important to have a strata that looks after your property, it doesn't have to be that hard to manage the change, especially if you're only dealing with a few owners. And if it is something that frustrates you, then maybe pay your property manager to go along to the strata meetings on your behalf and get him to make sure that everything's run properly. So in this case, I'm still going to purchase as well.